ما يجيب المضطر إذا دعا هو يكشف السوء أما 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 يجيب المضطر إذا دعا هو يكشف السوء
Being the Sharaf Shadi Majlis of Sara Rajani and Husnain Karim, Mumineen are requested to recite Surah Fatiha for their marhooms. And tonight's majlis is also sponsored for Marhuma Fatima Bai Haji Ismail, Marhum Sultan Bai Lilani, Marhum Hasan Ali and Shirin Bai Bandali and family and the Marhumins of their family Al Fatiha.
लाशे अकबर पे शाह जब पहुँचे दिल को हाथों से थाम कर बोले तेरी फुरकत ने ए अली अकबर आग दिल में मेरी लगा दी है आग दिल की बुझाऊं मैं कैसे तेरा लाशा उठाऊं मैं कैसे अकबर मेरा सहरिया वाला अकबर तू है करियल जवान ए बेटा बाप तेरा ज़ईफ है कितना नूर आँखों का हो गया रुखसत मुझको आता नहीं नजर खैमा लेके खेमों में जाऊं मैं कैसे लेके खेमों में जाऊं मैं कैसे तेरा लाशा उठाऊं मैं कैसे अकबर मेरा सहरिया वाला अकबर जिसने 18 साल पाला था कैसे देखेगी वो तेरा लाशा तेरी शादी का था जिसे अरमा कैसे झेलेगी वो तेरा सदमा तेरी माँ को बताओ मैं कैसे तेरी माँ को बताओ मैं कैसे तेरा लाशा उठाओ मैं कैसे अकबर मेरा सहरिया वाला अकबर भाई बहनों का है अजब रिश्ता जिसका सानी कहीं नहीं मिलता रोके सुगरा ने ये लिखा अकबर एक दुखियारी की लाज रख लेना मर गया तू बताओ मैं कैसे मर गया तू बताओ मैं कैसे तेरा लाशा اٹھاؤں میں کیسے اکبر میرا سحری حوالا اکبر اکبر میرا سحری حوالا اکبر
اعوذ باللہ من الشیطان اللعین الرجیم بسم اللہ الرحمن الرحیم لا حول ولا قوة الا باللہ العلی العظیم حسبنا اللہ ونعم الوکیل نعم المولى ونعم النصير نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونشكره ونصلي ونسلم على حبيب إله العالمين حافظ سره ومبلغ رسالاته الرسول المسدد المصطفى الأمجد المحمود الأحمد أبي القاسم محمد وبآله الطيبين الطاهرين المعصومين صلوات الله عليهم أجمعين ولعنة الله على أعدائهم ومنكر فضائلهم وغاصب حقوقهم من الأولين والآخرين من الآن إلى قيام يوم الدين أما بعد فقد قال الله تبارك وتعالى في كتابه المجيد بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم أحسب الناس أن يتركوا أن يقولوا آمنا وهم لا يفتنون صلوا على محمد وآل محمد Just by a mere claim, no one becomes a professional in any field. If one wants to claim anything that he is a professional in any field, he needs to be proved for argument's sake. If one wants to claim that he is a good driver, then he needs to give a test. Then he will get a license. If one claims to be a professional in any other field, he needs to be proved. Then only his word will be accepted that he is a professional in a particular field. Same applies to us. In Quran, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, أَحَسِبَ النَّاسِ أَن يُتْرَكُوا أَن يَقُولُوا آمَنَّا وَهُمْ لَا يُفْتَنُونَ What do men think? In Surah Ankabut, at the beginning of Surah Ankabut, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, what do men think? That them, by claiming that we brought iman, and they won't be tested? No, they will be tested. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, Amirul Mumin heard somebody claiming something. Amirul Mumineen heard somebody praying to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in the alleys of Kufa. And what was his prayer? He's praying to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that Allahumma inni a'udhu bika minal fitna. Now, fitna in Arabic means a test. Unlike our language. In our language, fitna means a discord or a quarrel or a fight or a corruption. But in Arabic language, fitna means a test. So now this guy prays in one of the alleys of Kufa, and Amirul Mumin overheard him. He says, oh Allah, I take refuge in you from the test. It means that I don't want to be tested. Allahumma inni a'udhu bika min al fitna. Now this is the sunnah of an imam or a prophet, that whenever he sees something wrong, he has to rectify. Say, if a prophet sees somebody performing wudu incorrectly, the prophet has to rectify that person. Or the imam has to speak out that this wudu is not correct. So Amirul Mumineen, when he hears him, Ali alayhi salam says that this dua is wrong. It is incorrect. You can never pray, and no one should pray, that Allahumma inni a'udhu bika minal fitna. Which means that, oh Allah, I take refuge in you from a test. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, there's no escape from fitna. There is no escape from the test, Amirul Mumineen says. The test is going to be there. Then Amirul Mumineen teaches him, and this is a lesson for you and I. Amirul Mumineen says that if you want to pray to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala regarding the test, then pray, Allahumma inni a'udhu bika min mudhillatil fitan. Which means that, O Allah, I take refuge in you from the failure of the test, so that I should not fail in the test. The test which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given us. We all are undergoing a test in this life. So you pray to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that may Allah not make you fail in this test, from the failure of the test. Because in history, there are many people who failed in this test. Like you have got Sa'ad bin Waqas in Saqifa. He was the companion of the Prophet, father of Umar Asad. Umar Asad himself failed in the test. Hassan bin Sabit failed in the test. Talha, Zubair, these were the companions of Rasulullah. Zubair was the cousin of Rasulullah. He was the son of the paternal aunt of Rasulullah. And you know, Imam Ali alayhi salam says that Talha was amongst us. He was from us. He is my cousin, Amirul Mu'minin says. Then his son Abdullah misguided him, deviated him, and he stood against me in Jamal. Personalities like Haris bin Hut, he was confused. Sometimes you are confused. You don't know where to go. He comes to Amirul Mu'minin and he says that, Ya Ali, where shall I go? Shall I support you? Shall I defend you? Or shall I defend the wife of the Prophet? On one hand, you have got the cousin of the Prophet. On the other hand, you have got the wife of the Prophet. I'm confused. Amirul Mu'minin doesn't say that support me. See the policy of Amirul Mu'minin. Ali alayhi salam says, "I'rif al-haq ta'rif ahla." Do you know where is haq and what is haq? And you will know who are the people of haq. Who are the people of truth? "I'rif al-haq ta'rif ahla." Now it goes without saying that Amirul Mu'minin wants to remind him that, remember, Rasulullah had said, "Aliyu ma'al haq wal haqqu ma'ali." Ali is with haq and haq is with Ali. So I'm on the truth. Come and defend me, support me. Amirul Mu'minin explains him. Ali alayhi salam says to that person that if you go and pray that, O Allah, I take refuge in you from the test that Allahumma inni a'udhu bika min al fitna, do know that awlad, children, and wealth themselves are fitna. Quran says, innama amwalukum wa awladukum fitna. Then Ali alayhi salam poses a question to him, that don't you love your children? Don't you want children? Don't you want mal? Mal is something good, wealth. Then why are you praying to God? And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says that wealth and children, they are the means of a test in this world. So if you pray to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that you take refuge in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala from these things, then you want to stay away from your children and from mal. Amirul Mumin tells him that, listen, children are not bad. Mal is not bad. Ali alayhi salam goes further and explains him that mal was good even for Sulaiman. Mal was good for Khadija. Balke Quran says in Surah Qasas, chapter 28, verse number 77, that seek akhira, future abode, with the means which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given you in this world. Right now, we are sponsoring a majlis, example. We are having, could we sponsor a majlis without money? No, in this materialistic world? No, in this era? In this day and age? No, nothing will happen without money. So money is not bad, Amirul Mu'minin is trying to explain us. He says, Sulaiman had also money. Khadija had wealth. It is not something bad. Balke Quran says, Al-malu wal-banun zinatul hayatul dunya. This is an adornment for this world. But then Quran goes forward. Quran says, Wal-baqiyatu salihat. What is going to remain forever is good deeds. It is deeds which is going to remain forever. Question. Then sometimes we do pose questions to ourselves and we try to think and ponder. Then if Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala knows everything, Allah knows who is going to be successful and who is not going to succeed in this life, then why he has to put test? Why has he put test for us? Sometimes you have got an instructor, he tells you that, listen, whoever comes here, sits here, I know when in 5 minutes' time I can know that whether he will succeed or not. A teacher can tell you that I know my student, whether he is going to succeed or not. So Allah knows more. Then why is he giving us test in this life? The answer is, Amirul Mu'minin goes forward. Ali alayhi salam says that, do you know why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gives test? Allah is testing us, because in that period of time when He is testing us, He wants to know that when you are bearing that test, are you patient or impatient? Are you having sabr or no? He wants to know your patience in each and every step. He wants to see you, how patient you are. Amirul Mu'minin says, and in regards to patience, and in regards to the test of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, there are three categories of people, the scholars say. The first category is jazu. Jazu, what does it mean? It means those people, they scream and shout and they complain to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in regards to the test of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That when they are tested in this world, they are complaining to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Quran says, innal insana khuliqa halu'a idha massahu sharru jazu'a. Quran says that man is created in a hasty temperament, being greatly grieved when evil afflicts him. Idha massahu sharru jazu'a. Why? Because they've got high expectation. That is why when evil afflicts him, they start complaining to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Why? Because of their high expectation. In the time of the Prophet of Islam, there were people, they had high expectations. Like they would say in Surah An'am, the story is there. In Surah An'am, Allah says that there were some people in the time of the Prophet, the polytheists of Makkah, the kuffar in Makkah, and they said that we won't embrace Islam and we won't accept this Prophet. Why? Because he has come in a form of a human. If he comes in a form of an angel, we will accept him. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says that they've got high expectation. If I would have sent Muhammad in a form of an angel, they would have said, why hasn't he come in a form of a human? Allah says that I have sent my prophet in a form of a human because it would be easy for Muhammad to relate with them, because they both are humans. But these people, out of their high expectations, that is why they are complaining. That is why they've got shikayat. Amirul Mumineen writes a letter to Ash'as bin Qais. When Ash'as bin Qais lost his son, Amirul Mumineen says that do not complain to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala because you lost a son. Because of this tragedy, do not complain to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Then Amirul Mumineen writes to him, to Ash'as bin Qais, listen, your son has already gone in the grave. By you complaining to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, your son won't come back. Then Amirul Mumineen continues. Amirul Mumineen says that when you complain to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, you will be ma'azur. Ma'azur means wizr, means you will be sinful. And when you are patient, when Allah is testing you, you will be ma'ajur, which means that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will reward you. Amirul Mumineen says, Allah will reward you. In the test, the first group of people are jazu', which means that they shout, they scream, they complain to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The positive example is of Imam Khomeini, rahimallahu alayhi. Imam Khomeini lost his son, Sayyid Mustafa. He was not a normal and an ordinary son. Sayyid Mustafa was a mufassir. He had written tafsir, an alim. Can you imagine that day when Imam Khomeini lost his son, Sayyid Mustafa? He did not call he continued his lessons. He was teaching his students. He did not call a day, that let's call a day today. No, Imam continued his lessons, Imam Khomeini. He says, I will teach. It's very difficult to lose a son, and not an ordinary son. A son who is an alim, who is a mufassir. But he did not complain to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So the first group is jazu. The second group is sabur. Sabur. The first group is not good group. We don't want to be from that group, from that category. The second group in regards to the test of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is sabur, which means those who are patient. When they are tested by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, they are patient, they are sabur. They are doing sabr. Again, sabr also, there are two kinds of sabr. Sabre adi and sabre jameel. When somebody loses a person, what we pray for them, we say that may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant you sabre jameel. And what is sabre jameel? Sabre jameel means a goodly patient. And what does it mean? It means that to be patient to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and not to complain to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Sabre adi means ordinary sabr. You are patient, but in the bottom of the heart, you have got some complaints to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sends salutations twice in Quran-i-Majid. One salutation is to the Holy Prophet. Inna Allaha wa malaikatahu yusalluna ala nabi. Ya ayyuhal ladhina amanu sallu wa sallimu taslima. This is Surah Ahzab, chapter 33, verse number 56. The second salutation, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sends salams to the patient ones. He says, وَبَشِّرِ الصَّابِرِينَ أُولَٰئِكَ عَلَيْهِمْ صَلَوَاتٌ مِّن رَبِّهِمْ. The second salutation is to the patient ones. Quran says that, and give the glad tidings to the patient ones. وَبَشِّرِ الصَّابِرِينَ أُولَٰئِكَ عَلَيْهِمْ صَلَوَاتٌ مِّن رَبِّهِمْ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, it is, Allah sends salutations to the patient ones. From their Lord, there is special salutations. أُولَٰئِكَ عَلَيْهِمْ صَلَوَاتٌ مِّن رَبِّهِمْ. So the second group is sabur. The third group is shakur. What does it mean? Shakur means they are grateful. This is the highest group, the highest level. They are grateful to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You'll find them saying, مَا رَأَيْتُ إِلَّا جَمِيلًا. We have not seen anything but beauty. They say, رِذَمْ بِقَضَائِهِ وَتَسْلِيمًا لِأَمْرِهِ. We are pleased with whatever Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has assigned to us. Whatever He has decreed for us, we are pleased with Him. This is the third category. They are shakur. They appreciate. They are grateful towards their Lord. Najul Balagha mein, khutbah number 156 mein, likha hai, ke Rasulullah ne Amir al-Muminin se kaha, Ya Ali, kaifa sabruka ala shahada. Tumhara sabr kaisa hoga, ay Amir al-Muminin? Jab tum shahadat paoge, Ya Ali. Aap jab shahadat paayenge, to aapka sabr kaisa hoga? To us waqt Amir al-Muminin ne farmaya, ke lais hadha laisa mawatin sabr, walakin hadha mawatin shukr. Imam farmate hain, Maulay Kainat farmate hain, ke jab mujhe shahadat milegi, اس وقت میں صبر نہیں کروں گا بلکہ میں شکر کروں گا. نجو بلاغہ میں خطبہ نمبر 156 آیت اللہ جواد یہ عاملی فرماتے ہیں کہ میرے مولا نے کتنی جنگیں لڑی. میرے مولا کو دنیا میں اور ان کی زندگی میں مولا کائنات کو کتنی کامیابی ملی, لیکن ان سب کامیاب میں امیر المومنین نے کبھی بھی نہیں فرمایا فزتو ورب الکعبہ. لیکن جب مولا کائنات کو شہادت ملی تب جا کے میرے مولا نے فرمایا فزتو ورب الکعبہ, کعبے کے رب کی قسم میں کامیاب ہوا. تو تین گروہ ہے. جب انسان کو امتحان آتا ہے خداوند کریم کی طرف سے, خدا جب اپنے بندے کو آزماتا ہے, ٹیسٹ دیتا ہے, تو انسان اپنے ڈیڈز کے مطابق, اپنے اعمال کے مطابق تین گروہ بنتا ہے. پہلا گروہ کیا ہے؟ جزو, جو خدا کے پاس شکایتیں کرتا ہے انسان. دوسرا گروہ کیا ہے؟ صبور, صبر کرتا ہے انسان مصیبت, اور جب مصیبت میں مبتلا ہوتا ہے تو خدا سے کچھ نہیں کہتا ہے بلکہ صبر کرتا ہے. اور تیسرا گروہ کیا ہے؟ وہ شکر کرتا ہے. کیا کہتا ہے؟ ما رأیت الا جمیلا. اب اہل البیت اطہار کبھی کبھار انبیاء کے بچوں سے بھی اور انبیاء سے بھی افضل اور بالا ترین ہے. اسماعیل سے جب کہا گیا, ابراہیم نے جب اسماعیل سے کہا کہ اے ابراہیم, اے اسماعیل, میں نے خواب دیکھا کہ میں تمہیں ذبح کرتا ہوں, تو قرآن کے مطابق اسماعیل نے کہا افعل ما تؤمر ستجدنی من الصابرین. آپ اپنا کام انجام دے بابا, آپ مجھے صابرین میں پاؤ گے. لیکن علی اکبر سے جب کہا گیا تو علی اکبر نے نہیں کہا کہ مجھے آپ صابرین میں پائیں گے. حضرت علی اکبر نے فرمایا کہ میں شکر کروں گا, بلکہ علی اکبر نے یہ کہا بابا اگر ہم حق پر ہیں تو موت سے کیا ڈرنا, موت ہم پر آ پڑے یا ہم موت پر گر پڑے کوئی مشکل نہیں ہے, کوئی فرق نہیں پڑتا ہے. ہاں, علی اکبر کی جب بات آتی ہے, التماس کیا گیا کہ علی اکبر کا ذکر کیا جائے, علی اکبر کو یاد کیا جائے. وہ جوان علی اکبر, باپ اور بیٹے کا رشتہ بہت عجیب رشتہ ہے کہ نہیں؟ हां जब अली अकबर मैदान जंग की तरफ जाते थे उस वक्त मेरे मौला ने अपने दस्त को बुलंद किया दस्ते मुबारक को बुलंद किया आसमान की तरफ फिर कहा पालने वाले गवाह रहना मैं अब उस फर्जंद को भेजता हूं जो सीरत में सूरत में रफ्तार में गुफ्तार में तुम्हारे रसूल का मुशाबे है हाजादारो जब अली अकबर जंग लड़के वापस आते हैं हमीद इब्ने मुस्लिम कहते हैं जब हजरत अली अकबर ने 120 अशकिया को सिले जहन्नम किया जब वापस आते हैं तो अपने बाबा से एक सवाल करते हैं बाबा प्यास मुझे मार डालती है बाबा थोड़ा सा पानी मिलेगा बेटा इतना बड़ा काम करके आया है किससे पूछता है सखी इब्ने सखी से सवाल करता है मुझे थोड़ा सा पानी मिलेगा लेकिन खैमे में एक कतरा पानी नहीं है मेरे मौला करे तो क्या करे कहा ए मेरे लाल आओ मेरे पास तुम्हारी सूखी जबान मेरे मुंह में डाल लो शायद तुम्हें कुछ तस्कीन आ जाए अजादारो एक मर्तबा अली अकबर ने अपनी जबान मेरे मौला के मुंह में डालते हैं लेकिन फौरन खींचते हैं फिर एक जुमला कहते हैं या अबता लिसानु का इबसु मिन लिसानी बाबा आपकी जबान तो बहुत ज्यादा खुश्क है मेरी जबान से हाजादारो आया अली अकबर नहीं जानते थे कि इमाम हुसैन बहुत प्यासे हैं लेकिन क्यों मौला अली अकबर ने कबूल किया अपनी जबान दी बाबा के मुंह पे शायद अली अकबर उस जुमले की तफसीर करना चाहते हैं कि मेरे मौला आशूर के दिन कहा था ए मेरे शियो जब भी ठंडा पानी पीना तो मेरी प्यास और मेरी गुर्बत को याद करना इमाम हुसैन इतने प्यासे थे कि जब चौथे इमाम ने मेरे मौला को सुपुर्दे खाक किया तो मेरे मौला सज्जाद ने इमाम हुसैन की कब्र पर अंगुष्ठ शहादत से लिखा हाजा कब्रुल हुसैन कुतिलात शाना ये उस हुसैन की कब्र है जिसको प्यासा शहीद किया गया أَلَا لَعْنَةُ اللَّهِ عَلَى الْقَوْمِ الظَّالِمِينَ وَسَيَعْلَمُ الَّذِينَ ظَلَمُوا أَيَّ مُنْقَلَبٍ يَنْقَلِبُونَ إِنَّا لِلَّهِ وَإِنَّا إِلَيْهِ رَاجِعُونَ رِضًا بِقَضَائِهِ وَتَسْلِيمًا لِأَمْرِهِ ظاہراً آج شرط شادی کی مجلس ہے ہم خداوند کریم کے پاس دعا کرتے ہیں کہ پالنے والے ہماری اس قلیل عبادت کو تیری درگاہ میں قبول فرما خدایا دولہا اور دلہن کے دل میں محبت پیدا کر محبت قائم کر اللہم الف بینہما کما الفت بین آدم و حوا اللہم الف بینہما کما الفت بین محمد المصطفی و خدیجۃ الکبریٰ اللہم الف بینہما کما الفت بین علی المرتضی و فاطمۃ الزہرا اللہم اعطی لہما اولادا صالحا وعمرا طويلا ورزقا واسعا حلالا طيبا برحمتك يا ارحم الراحمين او الله instill love in their hearts the way you instill love in the hearts of Adam and Hawa the way you instill love in the hearts of Muhammad and Khadija the way you instill love in the hearts of Ali al-Murtada and Fatima al-Zahra o Allah grant them with righteous children Allahumma a'ti lahum awladan saliha bless them with long life prosperous life umran tawila ورزقا واسعا حلالا طيبا برحمتك يا ارحم الراحمين ربنا هب لنا من ازواجنا وذرياتنا قرة اعين واجعلنا للمتقين اماما مؤمنين are requested to recite سورة فاتحة for the marhumins of Husnain and Sara and for all other marhumins سورة المباركة الفاتحة
سيأتي وارثة اللهم صل على محمد وعلى محمد بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم السلام عليك يا وارث آدم صفة الله السلام عليك يا ورث نوح النبي الله السلام عليك يا ورث إبراهيم خليل الله السلام